Welcome to Incognito Islamic Productions.
अब मैं क्या कहूं कि मुसलमान 1000 साल से बिल्कुल कुछ नहीं कर पाया है.
बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम. आई एम अदनान रशीद. ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, आई एम इन क्वारंटाइन, सेल्फ आइसोलेटिंग, एंड आई विल कंटिन्यू विद माय रिस्पॉन्सेज टू सम ऑफ द मिसकंसेप्शंस स्प्रेड बाय पीपल अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. यू जस्ट वॉच्ड अ क्लिप फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान वेयर बाय a pseudo-intellectual called Hood Boy made a statement, what have the Muslims done in the last 1,000 years? This is a very radical, extreme statement. Why? You will see why in due course. Hood Boy is a liberal secularist who is an activist in Pakistan promoting secularism, liberalism, and atheism. I don't know whether he is an atheist or not, but he seems to be promoting atheism, right? And how does he do that? By attacking Islam and the Muslim civilization. Deliberately spreading misconceptions, or he is completely ignorant. He's a physicist, he has a degree in physics, and he keeps talking about history for some reason. History is my field, I'm a student of history, so I will be talking about the history of Muslim civilization to show Hood Boy and his followers as to what Muslims have done in the last 1,000 years. The reason why he keeps mentioning the year 1,000 or the number 1,000 is because of Al-Ghazali. He believes that Ghazali simply killed science by criticizing Aristotelian logic in his books. So therefore, Ghazali is the murderer of science. This is what he believes. And because Ghazali killed science, all the Muslims who came after Ghazali also killed science, following on from what Ghazali had taught. But this is a gross misconception. This is a gross misrepresentation of the history of Ghazali as well as the Muslim civilization. If everyone was listening to Ghazali, then what were the Ottomans doing dealing with science? What were the Mughals doing? Because in the last 1,000 years, to talk about few major civilizations, if we put aside all the Mongol invasions, all the setbacks Muslims faced in the form of destructions of their libraries, destruction of their cities, entire civilizations were decimated. For example, the Mughals invaded the Muslim lands in the early 13th century, 1219 to be precise, when Genghis Khan came out with his army attacking Muslim lands, and he decimated the entire civilization of Islam from Central Asia all the way up to Syria. Him and his children, they did that. For almost 100 years, the Mongols went on destroying. Almost 10 million Muslims are killed. The Library of Baghdad, the largest library on the planet, was completely destroyed in 1258. And that happened within the last 1,000 years, right? I think you would think so. 1258. What we have lost in that library, only Allah knows. We do not have any idea as to how many books and what was the nature of those books. There were many books on science. We know that because they have been mentioned by later works that these books did exist, but now they cannot be found. Many books on philosophy, science, poetry, astronomy, okay, anatomy, medicine, for example, okay, there were books on pharmacology, there were books on all sorts of subjects, with theology, hadith, Quran, tafsir, biblical literature, other literature for that matter. Millions of books were dumped into the river Euphrates by the Mongols. Likewise, in 1492, when the Catholic monarchs took Granada, almost 2 centuries later, what happened? Millions of books were burned by the Catholics. Isabella and Ferdinand, both of them, they joined hands through marriage and they attacked the only remaining stronghold of the Muslims in Granada, and they burnt down the library. We cannot imagine what was lost there. All the contribution Muslim scientists, thinkers, philosophers, poets had made for all that time was completely lost, unfortunately. Now, where does this claim come from? People like Hood Boy and other extremists, whoever they may be, wherever they are, they make these claims of what have the Muslims done in the last 1,000 years. This claim is peddled again and again and again, repeatedly on mainstream channels, through these people, through these mouthpieces. And we don't clearly know who they work for, but they are either very ignorant or very malicious, because there are books written on that very topic as to how Muslims contributed for the last thousand years. Some of them actually claim that Muslims, whatever they did on science, was simply copying from the Greeks and others, right? Muslims did not write any original works. This lie is an Orientalist lie which is being peddled to this day. A lot of these Islamophobes and people who hate Islam and Muslims, what they do is they take Orientalist works from the 19th century, from German, from Dutch, from French, and from English historians, who were writing hostile works criticizing Islam because they were, because most of them were Christian, unfortunately, and they didn't like Islam due to colonialism as well, because India was colonized. Much of the Muslim world was colonized at the time. A lot of the Orientalists were writing hostile works to belittle the Muslim civilization and the contribution of the Muslim civilization, right? And they wanted to inflate the image of the colonial powers. They wanted to show the colonial powers as the civilizers of mankind. In order to do that, they had to belittle what happened before, right? So they tarnished the Muslim civilization and the history of Islam, not only in India, but elsewhere, okay? And then later on, some Orientalists realized, hold on, this is going too far. And they started to write books about the Muslim civilization, praising it. Hold on, it is not like that. There is a lot Muslims did. And people like John William Draper, who wrote a history of the intellectual development of Europe, in that book, he pays lavish tributes to the Muslim civilization. Like George Sarton in the early 20th century had written a book titled An Introduction to the History of Science. And this introduction, 70% of it is full of Muslim contribution. Throughout the last 1,000 years, okay? So here in this book, a very, very important book, it is titled The Hidden Debt to the Muslim Civilization, okay? It is authored by Al-Jazairi, S.E. Al-Jazairi, Hidden Debt to Muslim Civilization. This is an encyclopedia of information. It contains information and details on how Muslims studied the Greek science and other trends, and how they developed it, and then came up with their original works, criticizing, correcting, wherever necessary. So it has chapters on that topic. And people like Hood Boy and his followers, they keep peddling this idea that the Muslims are simply copyists. They were plagiarizers who simply copied the Greek science into the Arabic language, and then the Europeans came on later on, and then they translated these Arabic works into Latin, and lo and behold, the European Renaissance. Now, that is not the case. In fact, I will invite you to read another book titled The Origins of the Arabic Origins of the European Renaissance by George Saliba, okay, published by the Columbia University Press. The Arabic Origins of the European Renaissance. In that book, he argues that the science of astronomy came entirely from the Muslim world in its original form. In its original form, not simply a copied form of the Greek science. So this book is an encyclopedia of information. It will blow your minds away on this topic as to the Muslim contribution to science and other things. Not that the Muslims claim superiority over other civilizations. No, it's not like that. In fact, science was a global pursuit. It was a human pursuit. Romans did it. Greeks did it. Indians are doing it. The Persians did it, the Babylonians are doing it in their own way, the Egyptian civilization, 3,000 years history of it, okay? And then the Muslims came along and they took all these works and they put them together and they translated them into the Arabic language and produced their original researches and then put them forward to the rest of humanity. For 1,000 years, Muslims dominated this field. So people like Hood Boy, they exaggerate and they simply take ideas from 19th century Orientalists, which have been debunked. I strongly recommend another book by Edward Said, whereby he discusses the Orientalist attitude towards the Muslim world or the Arabs in general. And that book is titled Orientalism. Okay, now coming to the last 1,000 years. I mean, I don't have time to address all the Muslim contributions and Muslim works and Muslim history of science. In the last 1,000 years, I can quickly talk about the Ottomans and the Mughals, who were two major powerful dynasties in the last 1,000 years. Ottomans came to power, let's say, 1299 to 1924. That's almost 600 years. Ottomans dominated not only the Mediterranean, They dominated much of Europe as well as the Middle East and North Africa. And they produced immense works on science. In fact, there are books you can find online. If you were to Google Mr. Hoodboy and your followers, if you were to Google science and Ottomans, you will get so much literature that you'll be blown away. Another book I would like to mention very quickly is titled Intellectual Curiosity and the Scientific Revolution, right? It is by Toby E. Huff, published by Cambridge University Press. He has a chapter, okay, on the Mughals, how Mughals studied science and developed it. The chapter is titled The Discovery Machine Goes to the Muslim World. Here it is. And the first heading here is the Mughal India. Mughal India. He starts talking about how science was studied during the reigns of Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan, and Aurangzeb, right? If you picked up any books like that, Mr. Hoodboy, and your followers, you would know that Muslims have done a lot in the last 1,000 years. An immense contribution made to science and the development of the world. What changed all that is another question which I will quickly address in due course. Another book I recommend from you, Renaissance, is by Jack Goody, published by Cambridge University Press. Renaissance is, here he's talking about that the current study of history is entirely Eurocentric, just like it was in the 19th century. The Orientalists were Eurocentric thinkers. They were simply thinking, or they were simply conveying the idea that civilization only exists in Europe, or the white man only is civilized, not the rest of the world. Here, Jack Goody argues that Renaissances were taking place elsewhere too. For example, China and India. During the Mughal period, there was a renaissance there. So the renaissance was not only a European pursuit, rather it was happening elsewhere. It's just we don't study it. We don't see it with the same lens. So basically, we need to go back and study some of these works and see what Muslims have done. Very quickly, I want to mention passingly another figure who is very easily forgotten, Tipu Sultan. Okay, if you wanted to study what Muslims have done in science and technology in the last 1,000 years, I can give you, I have already given some examples. I can give you many more examples, but because the video needs to be short, I'll give you one precise example of Tipu Sultan, an immense figure in Indian history. A man who was struggling against the colonial rule of East India Company, and he had reached the heights of technological advancement. Okay, if you study the history of Tipu Sultan's technology, his production of weapons, for example, he outdid the French and the British in weapons production in Seringapatam, right? His innovations in silk farming, okay, or the farming of silkworms, for example, producing cloth, agriculture, right? And other pursuits when it comes to science, you will be shocked to read his history. He was a pioneer of rocket. Okay, he used military technology which shocked his opponents. And this is happening in between 1780 to 1799, right? 18th century. So what went wrong? What happened? Very quickly, colonialism, Mongol invasions, crusades, all of this put Muslims behind decades. Muslims are making very good progress. Okay. In fact, the Mongols, when they came into Muslim lands, they were shocked looking at the technology and the advancement the Muslims had achieved. Likewise, the Catholic monarchs, when they came to power in Granada, when they looked at the library, they were completely blown away. When they saw the Alhambra Palace, which is geometrical, okay, that happened within the last 1,000 years, they were completely blown away by the technology and the imagination of the Muslim artists. Okay, so all of this, you cannot forget it. In particular, study Tipu Sultan and his technology. You will be blown away, completely. You will be blown away. Colonialism and these invasions and all these disturbances, they put the Muslims... In fact, colonial power systematically worked in putting Muslims behind in technology. William Dalrymple talks about that in his book, Anarchy, his new book, Anarchy, where he talks about how East India Company worked hard in stopping the progress of the Muslims' power in particular in India, so that they cannot rise as opponents against the colonial ambitions of the East India Company in India. All of these things need to be consideration, and only a historian can do that, not a physicist. So, Mr. Hoodboy, yourself, I advise you to come back to sanity, to come back to objectivity, to be an objective academic and not be a hater, an extremist, hating Islam so much that you start to distort history. So this is an advice This is a humble piece of advice to you, Hood Boy, and your followers to study Islam objectively. Do not hate us so much that you start to distort history and start to remove it from your minds. And these are some of the books I have recommended. Thank you so much for listening. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullah. And more will be coming soon after.